I want to remind you, as I stated last night, that you are praying for those who hurt us. And this is a call for each and everyone, so that we can be able to enter in the presence of the Lord. We need to free ourselves from the hurts, from the pains that we have. Unless we offer them to the Lord, we cannot be able to enter deep in our prayers. And that's why I'm inviting you. Many people in our lives we have encountered, they have hurt us in one way or another. Others have spoken ill against us. Others have spoken many things that even we don't know how they created them. And sometimes they have affected us in one way or another, and we feel that we are not able to relate with them very well. But God is inviting us that before we offer an offering before his altar, we need to go and reconcile with our brothers and sisters. And this has to happen when we accept hearing deep within ourselves. People have hurt us in many ways. People have spoken ill against us, and this does not determine our destiny. Our destiny is in the hands of the Lord. As we start this moment of prayer, the book of Isaiah 43 from verses 18 to 19 says, "Remember not the events of the past, the things of long ago. Consider not. See, I am doing something new. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? It is in the desert I make a way. In the wasteland I'll make a way." Amen. The word of the Lord is reminding us that we should not consider the things of the past, because God is going to do something new in our lives. And this only happens if we release any pain, any affliction that we have received from other people. They affect us or infect us. And when we live with people, we have to collide, but we have to let go. Many people have destroyed our destiny, and they have made it a standstill, but God is going to do something new. And that is why he is telling us, remember not the things of the past, because I am going to do something new in your life. As we start this moment of prayer, praying for those people who have hurt us, praise those people who don't wish us well, praying for those people who have destroyed our destiny in one way or another, is a call to let go. It is painful. We have to cry. We have to pass agony, but we have to let go and allow God to do something in our lives so that blessings can have a way in our lives. We have to release. We have to let go. We have to let go. We have to let go. And we start new. For the Lord says in the Romans 8:38, says, "In all these things, what can we say of these things? If the Lord is for us, who can be against us?" It is not friends, it's not persecution, it's not everything, anguish, all anything that we pass through that can separate us with the love of Christ. God loves us so much, and he gave his only son so that whoever believes in him will never perish, but will have eternal life. As I continue, that the Lord in James chapter 4, verses 10, the Bible says, "Humble yourself before the Lord, and he will exalt you." We are called to humble ourselves. Humble yourself before the Lord, and he will exalt you. The Lord resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. That is James 4, 6. God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. As we humble ourselves before his presence, He is telling us, fear not. In Isaiah 43:1-2, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by my name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. In the rivers, you shall not be drowned. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned. The flames shall not burn you. Praise God. As we reflect those words, let us pray for those who hate us. Let us pray for those who have caused her pain. And as we enter this moment of prayer, I invite you, because of schedule of work, maybe at 8:30 to 9, we shall be having a divine mercy, joined together, praying for those who have hurt us. So I invite you, sometimes I'll be putting a live video, praying for reducing the divine mercy as we join together. And I wish you all the best this week. May God bless you. May God see you through. Amen.